Hi, welcome to a new workout. Today we're going to do a HIIT cardio workout. You don't need any equipment, so get ready and let's start. Okay, here we go. Starting this workout with a short warm-up before we go over to the main exercises. So get ready, start. And step and swing. So 5 exercises to warm up a bit. And then main workout, an intense HIIT cardio today. We do 45 seconds on and 15 seconds active rest to re-catch your breath. And I think we're going to need those 15 seconds today. We will do 5 exercises in the first round, repeating twice. Then we have a water break. Over to the second round. 5 different exercises, repeat it twice again. And of course, we finish with a cool down, a bit of stretching at the end of this workout. But first, swing your arms and get those steps in. Warm up a bit. Get a heart rate up, get the blood flow going, and prepare yourself for an intense main cardio workout. Final swings. And then we're going to circle the arms. So what we're going to do is we step to the side and circle the arms. So when you step to right, circle that right arm. When you step to left, circle that left arm. Big circles. Don't go too fast. You need your air in the main workout. So I hope you brought a towel to this workout, because sweat is guaranteed. And of course, you can always adjust the workout on your own pace, on your own fitness level, like always. No jumping exercises. But if you work out often with me, you know that doesn't mean it can be an intense workout. So final circles. And then we go to the lower body for some leg swings. So final circle, and that's it. What we do is a swing, friend. We walk back and swing the other leg up. You don't have to swing as high as you can. It's all about getting the blood in the legs, loosen up the thighs a little bit, the hips, because we're going to do some big steps in the main workout, and also some leg kicks, some high knees. We're going to use the arms. So a lot of combination moves. And you can slow down, you can speed up. So everyone can follow this workout. So keep on swinging, just a few more. Right and left. And then after the swings, we're going to warm up the calves. One more swing, arm right, and finish on left. And now, focusing on a little bit on the balance, of course, but mostly on the calves, because what we're going to do is we pulse up and then down, up and down. So come on your toes, make a little pulse, up and then back down, up and back down. Warming up the calves, and of course at the end, we're going to stretch the calves as well, because we're going to do a lot of steps up, a few more, and one more, and that's it. Okay, find your balance. What we're going to do is we're going to rotate the lower leg. So what we're going to do is we lift the knee up, making rotations from the knee till the end of the leg to the feet. And reverse that circle. Find that balance. Don't lock your standing knee, your standing leg. Keep it slightly bent. Find your balance and rotate that lower leg over to the other side. Right leg. Circle out. Circle, circle, circle. Loosen up the knees a little bit and reverse that circle to the inside, rotations, and That's it. Okay, shake it out. And now we are good to go over to the main workout. In 20 seconds, we're starting. So if you need a sip of water, take it fast because we're going over to the main exercise. The first one looks maybe a little bit easy, but you can speed it up. But we're going to do a side step and both arms are going to left. When we step to right, both arms are going to right. So we're swinging the arms from left to right, making big steps. There we go, over to the left side. So make some steps from side to side and swing those arms over. Of course, engage your abs. So pull the belly in, go down at the end a little bit. That's it. It's time to get that heart rate up. Getting the steps in, swing those arms over, left and right. Tap it from side to side. Big steps, big swings. Keep the arms up. 45 seconds active, and then 15 seconds to really catch the breath, going over to the next exercise. Almost there. Swing it, last one, and that's it. Okay, that's it, first exercise. Stay active, re-catch your breath in between the exercises. The next one is a low tap back repeater. So we're tapping that rear back, left back, staying down low, so come on. Tap it back, and tap your heel, hop. Tap it, tap it. And of course, move those arms along. Slightly bending over, keep your back straight. We do about 22 seconds one side, then we switch, and we switch right now. So keep that standing leg slightly bent. You don't have to go deep, just keep that knee slightly bended, and tap it back. Move your arms, and pull the belly in. Come on, back tap repeater. Final seconds. And that's it. Okay, coming up, shake it out. Right, catch your breath, so take a deep breath in. And the next exercise is a stepping jack. So we make a big step from side to side, and we tap the ends above our head, tapping the outside of the leg. So come on, hop. Arms are going all the way up, all the way down. With big steps, of course. Left and right. Keep your knees slightly bended. Upper body straight up. And keep going. Big steps, stepping jacks. Up and down, up and down. Come on. Arms going up and down. And big steps. No small steps. It's not enough. Come on, big ones. Pump it. That's it. 10 more seconds. From left to right. And the last one, that's it. Okay, the next one is a standing straight up. What we're going to do is fast butt kick. So protect your butt, hands on your butt. And what we're going to do is we really kick those heels towards your butt. Straight up, and there you go, left and right. Hop. So keep your legs slightly bent. Pulse it a little bit and kick it. Come on. Working your hamstrings, curling those legs, and engage your abs. Come on, pull the belly in, upper body straight up, and kick it. Come on, your hands are there to protect your back so you can kick it hard. Come on, 15 seconds. From left to right, get that heart rate up. Kick it, kick it, kick it. Keep on curling that leg. Left and right. Final ones. That's it. Great job. Now my hands are almost red from all those kicks. The final exercise in the first round is a leg kick repeater. What we do is one leg is going in front, we kick and tap back. So come on. Kick, back. Tap your leg in front, tap it back. And again, your standing leg is slightly bent. Keep on kicking. Come on, swing and kick. About 22 seconds on one side, then we switch over. That means now. Come on, hop. No rest in between that switch. Just bring that leg up in front. Swing it up. Tap it back. That's it. Come on, kick it. Swing your arms as well. That's it, 5 seconds left. Up, kick it. Last one, and that's it. Ah, that's amazing. We're halfway in the first round. So come on, focus on re-catching that breath. And we're going over to the step swings. Come on, to right, up. And that's it. Come on. Keep that heart rate up. You're halfway in that first round. 5 exercises. Then you have that water break. So swing your arms over. Left and right. Big steps. Pull the belly in. Engage your abs. Engage your core. That's it. Keep your chest up. Shoulders low. Only arms are swinging. From left to right. That's it. Come on. Keep making those steps. Left, right, left, right. Final ones. And that's it. Lower your arms down. Shake it out. Stay active. And we're going back to those back tap repeaters. Like you're running. So come on. And there we go. Tap it. Tap it. Stay on one side, 22 seconds, then switch. Keep your front leg slightly bent. You don't have to go deep, just don't lock that knee. You can tap as fast as you want to tap. Move your arms along, back and forth, up. One more, switch over. Keep on tapping. Now your right leg is slightly bent, up. Come on, move those arms, tap it back. Keep your back straight, 10 seconds. Tap it, tap it. Come on, don't slow down. And that's it. Okay, come on up. Over to the stepping jacks in 10 seconds. So have your rest. Don't stand still, but slow down, recover. It's an interval. So there we go, stepping jacks right now. Step it. And I want to see those arms all the way up, all the way down. Stepping big steps from left to right. Up, down, come on. Have a minute of stepping jacks left. Come on, pump those arms up and down. Keep that heart rate up, you can do it. Up, and down. 15 seconds. Keep up that pace. You're doing great. Come on. Left, up, right, up. And the last one. That's it. Okay, two more before the water break. The next one is the fast butt kicker. So upper body straight up. Hands on your butt. Get ready to kick some ass. And there we go. Curl it. Left and right, hop. Come into that wide stand, slightly bend the knees, and kick, kick, kick. That's it. Left and right alternating. Curl, let those hamstrings work, and kick it. Keep your upper body straight up. Come on, lift the chest up, shoulders low. That's it, 20 seconds left. Keep on kicking, bring those heels up. Up and up. Don't slow down. Come on, keep the pace. Final seconds. And almost there. That's it. Okay, shake it out. Awesome. The next one is that leg kick repeater, and it's the final one of the first round. Then you have that break. So come on, one leg in front, upper body straight, and starting to kick. Up. Up. So you tap it back and swing that leg up. That's it. Standing leg slightly bent. Engage your abs. Come on and swing it. Bring that leg up. 22 seconds one side. Then we switch. And we switch right now. Over to right. Tap back and kick. Come on. final 15 seconds of the first round. Don't quit now. Keep going. Swing that leg up. Almost there. And that's it. Well done. Now, time to take your rest. Drink some water. Recatch your breath for the next round. We do 5 different exercises. Same sequence, 45 seconds on, 15 seconds active rest, and we finish with a cool down. Okay, here we go for that second round. We do 5 different exercises, starting with the cross front taps. And of course, those arms are crossing as well. So get ready, 45 seconds. Here we go. Cross those arms and tap those legs in front. When you tap it, slightly go down, just a little bit. And open those arms up with power. Come on. Upper body straight up. Pull that belly in. And here we go again for that second round. 5 exercises, repeating twice. Keep going, cross and open. 15 seconds left. Come on, power in those arms. Cross, open, and tap it. Final ones. Keep your arms up and now, lowering down. That's it, first exercise of the second round. Next one is high knees, but not only high knees, arms are going up, and we're going to tap under the knees. So, come on, arms up, there we go. Up, up. So bring those hands up above your head, and then lift your knees up, take your hands under, up. And of course, that upper body stays straight up, so you do not bring those chests down. And doing this, come on. Upper body straight up. And those arms are going up and down. Lifting the knees up. Come on, hop. Lift those knees towards your chest. Left and right. Left, right. Left, right. 10 seconds. Come on, arms up and down. Keep going. Almost there. And that's it, last one. Great job. The next one is a double side tap reach. So you're standing straight up, we double tap and double reach. High up, double on each side. Start on left right now, double and right. So standing like a slightly bend when you tap to the side and pump that arm up. Right, left, double. That's it. Come on, pump it up in the air and tap to the side. Double left, double right. I have to be more in the corner. I reach my ceiling there. Up. Come on, double. Right, double, left, double. Reach it up. Up, up. Come on. Bring that hand up in the air. Final one on left. Finish on right, and that's it. Okay, for the next one, we're going slightly down on the legs, just a slight knee bend, not too deep. We're going to tap and raise that elbow up, working the shoulders a bit. Lean over a little bit, keep your back straight, and there we go. Left, right, come on. Make yourself a fist, elbow is going up. Stay down low just a little bit. And tap it, left, right, on your own pace. That's it, keep going, come on, power, lifting that hand up, up, left, tap it, stay down just a little bit, 15 seconds left, you can do it, come on, tap it, and bring those elbows up, final seconds. And that's it. Come on up, shake it out. Final exercise of the first round is a twist and a punch. So we're twisting in from side to side, 45 seconds, and then repeating the set already. So come on, over to right, punch it. Tap and twist. Upper body is straight up. You're just twisting those shoulders from left to right, making those punches. That's it. Slightly bend the knees. Don't lock it. Engage your abs, so pull that belly in and twist it. Keep going. Come on, power and twist. Left, right, left. 15 seconds left. And then repeating the round. And we are halfway in that second round already. Come on, final ones. Punch it and twist it. And that's it. Great job. 5 exercises, repeating again now. And then we are in the center of the second round. So the next one is that front cross step again. Straight up and start. Tap and cross. Come on. Close and open your arms. Cross it in front with power. The more power you put in those arms, the more the heart rate goes up. Come on, tap it. Swing those arms, pump it. Keep your upper body straight up, chest up, shoulders low, and don't lower those arms down. Come on, open and close. Power, 15 seconds left. Keep tapping. Slowly bend the knees. Come on, don't slow down. Keep up that pace. Final seconds, and that's it. Now lower your arms down. And we're going over to the knee lifts with the taps under. Arms are going all the way up and then coming together. So that's it. There we go. Arms up and go. Lifting. Hop, hop. So bring the knees up towards your chest. Upper body straight up. And bring those arms down and up. Come on. Up, up, up. That's it. Work those arms. Keep that heart rate up. That's it. 20 seconds left. Keep your upper body straight up. You can do it. Keep up that pace. Arms up, down, up, down. 10 seconds. Almost there. Keep going. Lift those knees up a little bit higher. And that's it. Great job. Stay active. Right, catch the breath a little. We're going over to the double tap reach. Double on each side. So take a deep breath and start. Come on, double. And left, double. Right, double. So tap to the side as far as you can and reach out. Arm up and down. Yes, that's it. Upper body straight, belly in. Come on, double right, double left. Hop, hands up, double. Keep going, 15 seconds. Don't lock those knees, keep them slightly bent. And pump it. Come on, stay active. Don't quit. Last one. That's it. 2 more exercises. And then cool down. The next one is a little bit down low. Tap to the side. Raising those elbows up. So get ready and go. Singles. Singles. Raise it up. Tap to the side. From left to right. Tap it left, left elbow, tap it right, right elbow. And that's it. From side to side. And stay down low just a little bit. Come on. Speed it up as fast as you can. Come on, give it. Challenge yourself to the max. 15 seconds left. Come on, left and right, right and left. Tap it. Stay down, don't come up, come on. Final seconds, and that's Here, come on up. Shake out your legs. Over to the final exercise. And that's the twist box. Keep that upper body straight up, just twisting that upper body, working your obliques as well. So come on. Final exercise. 45 seconds, power, and then you're done. So come on. Don't quit now. Stay up. Keep that heart rate up. And punch it. Come on. It's the final one. You're almost there. 20 seconds. Come on. Twist. Punch, punch, punch. Yes. Come on. Quit. Don't stop. Final seconds. Punch it hard. Last ones. That's it. Wow. What a workout. Great job. And of course, you finish that main workout, but don't stand still. Don't drop that on the floor. Stay up and do that cool down with me. So steps in, focus on that heart rate. Take some deep breaths in, lower that heart rate down. Time to recover from this workout. So make the steps, slow it down, but keep moving and lower your heart rate down. And when you're ready, then tap and swing. Releasing the tension out of the arms, the shoulders, because like I said, we did a lot of arms moves. So it's a great way to use your arms to get that heart rate up. Swing it over. Swing it over and take some time for that recovery. We're going to do some stretches after we lowered that heart rate down. And I guess we are ready for some stretches. We're starting just with a reach. So come into a little wide stance. Never lock your knees, so keep them slightly bent. Tuck that belly in, upper body straight up. And then raise your left arm up in the air and then bend over to the right side. Feeling that stretch on your left side. Open up a little bit, so open your chest, lean back a little bit, and you feel that stretch more in your abs. And release over to the other side. Right arm is going up, bent over to the left side. Keep your chest in front and reach out as far as you can so you can feel that stretch on that right side right now. And then twist your chest open, lean back a little bit, feeling that stretch on your abs. Lean back, reach out, still keep making that reach, and release. That's it. Okay, over to the lower body. Because we did a lot of low steps, slightly bending the knees, but ever when we make that slight bend, you need your quads and your glutes. So we're going to stretch the quads right now. Find your balance. Grab your left foot or your ankle, whatever you can reach, and pull that heel towards your butt as far as you can so you can feel that stretch. And if you reach your butt and you can still not feel that stretch, then pull that knee back a little bit, chest in, up, and bring the hips in front. And then you can definitely feel that stretch on your hip, on your quad. Find that balance. Ooh. There you go. And switch over to the other side, of course. Grab your right foot or your ankle, whatever you can reach, and then pull the knees together, knee back a little bit, and feel that stretch. Don't lock that standing leg. Keep it slightly bent. Feel that stretch. And really shake it out. Place that right foot in front. Now you can lock your knees because we're going to stretch the hamstrings. So bring that chest towards the front knee and you can feel that stretch in your hamstring. Great, after those butt kicks, it's a lot of curls in the legs, a lot of effort for the hamstring. So bring that chest a little bit closer to your knee if you can, feeling that stretch, and then bend your knees, roll up, and then switch over to the other side. So left is going in front, right to the back, Lock your knees, so stretch it. And then bringing the chest towards your knee. Feeling that in the left hamstring. And I can feel it in my calves as well. A little bit by pressing the heels down. But focus on stretching your hamstring. Bring the chest to your leg. Feeling that stretch. Just hold it a few more seconds. And then bend your knees, roll up. And we're going to do one final exercise to release the tension out of the legs. So a little wide stand, bend your knees just a little bit. And what we're going to do is we just roll off. So let your shoulders go down, go down, go down. As far as you can, keep your knees bent. We won't want to stretch the hamstrings too much anymore. And then just swing over from left to right, left to right with your whole upper body. And then come in center and just swing your arms. Swing your arms. Releasing the tension out of the shoulders. And then just rolling up slowly, slowly, slowly. Finish with a shoulder roll, standing straight up. And that's it. You can be so proud of yourself for finishing this intense HIIT cardio workout. So give yourself that well-deserved thumbs up. You definitely deserve this today. Of course, always, but mostly today, because this was a very intense workout. So I hope you liked it. You had a great workout. Leave a comment, subscribe to the channel, put on those notifications so you won't miss any of the upcoming workouts. Invite your friends. Let's grow this community. Thank you, and see you in the next workout.